This video will show you how to install TC Python and the required accompanying programs. The video will also show you how to open the examples files that were shipped with the software and how to create new examples so that you can get started working in TC Python. In this video, I will use a Windows computer, but the process is similar on Mac and Linux operating systems. I'll address the differences during the video, so you can follow along if you use either of those systems. There are two ways to install TC Python, and this video will show you the simpler way, which bundles several popular Python packages with the Thermo-Calc installation, as shown on the screen. This is the recommended option for users who are new to TC Python, but it is limited to the pre-installed packages. If you want more flexibility in the program, or intend to use additional packages, we recommend you use the more advanced method, which you can read about in the TC Python installation guide. However, if you plan to develop or run property models in TC Python, it is strongly recommended that you use the method shown in this video. The first step in this process is to install Thermo-Calc as you normally would. If you already have Thermo-Calc installed, skip ahead to the next step. If you do not already have Thermo-Calc installed, install it now using the default settings. TC Python and the bundled packages automatically install with Thermo-Calc. If you need assistance installing Thermo-Calc, refer to the installation guides available in the Support Center on our website, or visit our video library to find the correct video. If you're watching this video on YouTube, there are links in the description. The next step in the process is to install an Integrated Development Environment, or IDE for short. Any editor will work, but we recommend that you use PyCharm, which is an open source software that gives you access to advanced features such as code completion. If you already have an IDE installed, you can skip ahead to the next step. To install PyCharm, navigate to the URL shown on the screen. Once you're there, find the version you want to install and download it. The free community version is sufficient for working with TC Python. You can pause this video while the software is downloading. Once the software has been downloaded, navigate to wherever the downloaded files are stored on your computer. Find the PyCharm installer and double-click on it to start the installation. Install it according to the instructions. We recommend that you keep all the default settings. Once PyCharm is installed, we want to open the examples folder included in your Thermo-Calc installation. Open PyCharm and click Open. Navigate to the TC Python folder using the paths shown on the screen. If a pop-up window appears asking you to trust the source, click Trust Project. Click Project on the far left of PyCharm. The different example folders should now be listed in the left pane. To run a calculation with TC Python, we need to configure PyCharm to use the bundled Python interpreter. In PyCharm, click the No Interpreter text at the bottom right corner. Click Add New Interpreter, Add Local Interpreter. In the left menu, click System Interpreter. Then click on the three dots to the right of the interpreter. Navigate to the Thermo-Calc Python 3 interpreter on your system. It is located in a different place depending on your operating system, as shown on the screen. Select your added interpreter, then click OK on both windows. You want to use this interpreter for all your TC Python projects. Therefore, it can be useful to rename the interpreter so that you can distinguish it from other interpreters. To do this, click Python 3.7 in the bottom right corner of the window and click Interpreter Settings. In the drop-down list, click Show All, and in the new window, click the Rename button and write the new name of the interpreter. I will name it Python 3.7 Thermo-Calc. Click OK, Apply, and OK again. You should now see the new name in the bottom right corner of PyCharm. For Mac installations, you need to set some environment variables, which I will go through next. If you are on a Windows computer, you can skip to the next step. In PyCharm, you can add environment variables in the configurations. From the top menu, select Run, Edit Configurations to open the Run Debug Configurations window. Click Edit Configuration Templates. Choose Python, and click the button to the right of the Environment Variables text field. In the Environment Variables window, click the plus sign to add a new environment variable. The environment variables you want to add are listed in the TC Python Online Help. Enter the purple text as the name and the text after the equal sign as the value. Click Apply on all three windows to return to your project. It should be noted that changes to the template will not change existing run configurations. They need to be deleted to obtain the new template settings. To run any of the examples, click Project from the left menu and expand any of the folders to reveal the examples. Note that two of the examples will not run without additional packages installed, as shown on the screen. To run any of the other examples, double-click on the example file to examine the code, then right-click anywhere on the code and select Run. If you set up everything correctly, you should see the example running in the Run pane. Once the calculation is complete, the results will appear in a separate window in the form of a plot. If the calculation did not run correctly, visit the troubleshooting guide in the TC Python Help. Next, we want to create a new project where we can write and perform our own TC Python calculations. From the top menu, click File, New Project. Here you can choose which Python interpreter to use. You can either use a new environment or a previously configured interpreter. We want to use our previously configured interpreter, so select that option. From the drop-down list, make sure to select the interpreter that you configured and renamed before you ran the example calculations. Click Create and choose to open the project in a new window. Your new project will then be opened in a separate window. Right-click on the project folder in the left menu and select New, Python File. Name the file as you like. You are now ready to write your own TC Python script. We hope you found this video useful. You can learn more about TC Python at the TC Python videos page on our website. Don't forget to press the like button, and feel free to leave a comment about the type of video you'd like to see next. We are constantly working to create new examples, so make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any new videos. You can watch all of our videos at thermocalc.com in the video tutorials section.